Carly. I'm the event and development coordinator here. So I really appreciate you guys all coming out this morning. You know, it's cold and the weather is not great, so thank you for still making the trip over here. We should be out by 10, but if anyone does need to leave early, it's not a problem at all. I just appreciate you guys coming. So basically the reason for this workshop is we do have a lot of community events throughout the year. We try to attend most of them as long as we have the capacity to do so. The community events are super important, so that way we can get our organization known throughout the community, let people know the work that we're doing, give people opportunities to get involved. Some people in the Forsyth County area still don't even really know we're here, which I know for some of you guys it's quite hard to imagine, but there's definitely people that don't know about us. And sometimes those are the people that need us the most. So we really want everyone to kind of know that we're here as a resource and we're available to help in the community. So we try to go to the events, like I said, raise awareness, educate people, be available for questions, and stuff like that. So that's the importance of our community events. And unfortunately, sometimes there's multiple on the same day. So that's really when we do need you guys. I can be at one, but I can't be at both at once. So it's really helpful to have volunteers to go to those other events, and also sometimes just to like tag along with me. As we get to the event card portion, you'll see it can be a lot for one person to handle. So it's really helpful to have that second person there in case you need help with anything. As we go through, if you guys have any questions, please feel free to like raise your hand or just call out to me, and then at the very end of everything, I'll have like a time for questions as well. So I want to make sure that you guys leave here feeling prepared to help with our events and confident in doing so. So the first thing is signing up for events. So to do that, Allie over here is our volunteer coordinator, so she's really going to be your big point of contact as well. And she typically will send out emails to volunteers, letting them know about events coming up. And then there's also a FHS Volunteer and Foster Facebook group, so she'll post about them in there as well. So that way you guys know what's going on event-wise and know the opportunities available for you. You can also, website has them as well. And you also can just like reach out to her or me, and we can let you know as well what's kind of going on. We typically plan for the following month. So like right now, I'm already looking into February to kind of see what kind of events are going on, what we can be a part of. So we'll have those available shortly, so that way we can go ahead and make sure that we have the capacity to be there, sign up, and get everything organized for that. So once you sign up for the event, your Allie, she'll pass it along to me, your name and your email, and from there, I'll email you a couple days before the actual event to give you any further details that I have. I've noticed a lot of times there'll be an event that they don't even 100% know exactly what's going on until a day or two before. So therefore, I can't let you guys know what's going on, and I really want you guys to feel prepared, know where you're going, what time you have to be there, how to get there, what you need, all that good stuff to set you guys up for success. So just look out for an email from me, probably a couple days, potentially even the night before. Like I said, I can't let you guys know until I know, but I'll do my best to let you know ahead of time what's going on. I also really want to include a point of contact for the event, so that way if you were to show up there and you can't figure out exactly where you need to go, there'll be a person's name and a number to call. Because like I said, if I'm not there with you, I'm not a ton of help. Once you're already there, can't really do a whole lot. I've been to two events myself where I like show up and then there's no signs and I don't really know where I'm going, and it can be kind of frustrating and confusing. So there should be a point of contact for you guys to call if you get there and have questions. I'll also include what stuff from the cart that you need to take. Most of the time, the table will have to go. That's part of the reason it's kind of a two-person job. Someone can carry the table, someone can roll the cart, instead of having to make multiple trips. And occasionally there are events where you have to take a tent. That's another reason it's helpful to have a second person to help set it up, to help carry everything. And I'll let y'all know. We'll walk back at the end of this to show you where the tent is, as well as where these event carts are kept. When you come to pick up the cart, Like I said, I'll show you guys exactly where those are. But I will already make sure that everything you need is in the cart. So you don't have to worry about looking around in the office or the front desk for anything extra. It's all gonna be loaded in here. And like I said, it can be a lot, but a lot of stuff in here is fun. That's why we kind of rebooted our carts, because we want to improve our appearance at these community events. We want people to know that this table is from the Forsyth Humane Society. We want it to look like there's stuff to go look at, stuff to engage with, so that people come up and like talk to you and ask questions and engage with you instead of sitting there for 3 hours without a single person even looking your way. I've also been to events like that, and that's also not super fun, especially if you're going to an event anticipating, like, getting to share about how much you love the Humane Society and all the good work that we do, and how people can get involved and stuff like that. So that is the reason we kind of revamped these and have some new stuff in there. So I'm going to just go through setting up the table itself. There's no, like, certain place anything needs to be on the table, but as I set up, I'm just going to kind of explain what everything is, so that way you guys know all of the things in this cart. I have Allie actually help me set up the table. Like I said, that is why two people, so if you have a friend or a relative or anyone that wants to help you or attend an event with you, it is super important. Yeah, as we struggle. as well as a sign-up sheet. So people can put their name, their email, and or phone number, and if they're interested in fostering or volunteering. So when I get back from an event, anyone who's interested in volunteering, I pass off to Allie, and then anyone interested in fostering, I pass off to our foster team. If they're interested in something else, they can just put like adoption or resources or whatever it may be. And once I get this back, I'll give it to the right person so that way they can be contacted. We have a fish bowl as well, so if people want to donate with cash, they can do so in here. We do have several other ways to donate. So if people don't have cash, you know, it's a lot less common for people to carry cash nowadays. We do have a handy dandy dip jar. So the cord just plugs into the bottom. This is the battery pack for it, so I'll make sure it's charged and have it already connected most likely, but if it's not, it just plugs into the bottom here. It'll do its little song to turn on. Says hello. It usually takes it a minute, so we'll let it finish its loading process. But how it works is it'll say the dollar amount on here. So right now it's set at $5. That's typically what it's going to be set at. People can insert their credit card. It'll do a little. It'll change to like an insert sign, like an arrow down. And when it's ready for them to remove their card, it just puts an arrow up so that you know you can pull it back out. If it processes, if it makes that sound, that the money went through. Every now and then, it does like give people issues where it just doesn't read their card, which is possible that that would happen. We just let people know they can go donate online if their card's not working or if they have another method to donate. They can do that. But people do really love these. I've had people donate just because it's a dip jar and people like it and think it's cool and high tech, so they enjoy those. There are also some like little, yes.
Are you able to change the amount if someone wants to donate more than $5?
So you wouldn't be able to change it from the event. I have to change it from my computer, but we just encourage people if they want to do a 10, they can just dip once. Yep. These signs are in here as well. They'll change. They're just like different programs that we may have highlighted at that time of year. If you run out of room on the table, they don't necessarily need to go up, but they will be in there, and they have QR codes on them for our Venmo, so people can Venmo us if that's their preferred method of donating. Alright, here is my new favorite part. So we have a spinning wheel. So people can win different FHS prizes and gear. Please only let people spin once. Everyone in like a group or family can spin, but we do have like a limited number of like prizes that we're able to purchase. So we'll get a spin. Let's see what I'm gonna win. Okay, so you guys can keep this like with you behind the table, wherever you want. We have cups with our logo on it. It says Adopt Foster Volunteer Outreach on the back. We have little buttons with our logo on it that people can pin on things. We have mini frisbees with our logo on it as well. Red pens with the Human Study logo. A variety of stickers, so I'm gonna try and keep them in a Ziploc so they're not like scattered all over, but there's a bunch of different designs. If any of you guys know Chase, he actually designed them, so that's super cool. He's a staff member here. And then we have leashes and collars. So there's multiple leashes in here. I just didn't want to unpack it and have them get all tangled. And then collars as well.
We only have a big collar.
We have some small ones clipped onto another small.
Oh, okay.
Yes. I that's my new favorite part. I've been to a lot of events and festivals and stuff, and people have a wheel that like automatically attracts people. They're like, I want to spin, get something for free. So. Okay, the next thing is, we have TV monitors, so that way we can play a slideshow at our events that shows all of our programs. They're going to be kept in this box just to protect it a little bit. I might try and find like a better like sleeve for the TV, so that way you don't have to carry this whole box around in the cart. But for right now, it came in the box on Wednesday, and they'll have it in the box. So the TV is inside of this wrap. And there's also a USB drive in there. I'm also trying to figure out what I can tie through this tiny little thing so that way it's connected to something bigger so it doesn't get lost. If it gets lost, it's not the end of the world. It just has a slideshow on it from the Humane Society, so it's okay. But I'm hoping by the time you guys volunteer at events, I'll have this connected to something larger so it's not lost in the mix of everything going on. Right. So, we already know we have a little TV. It does have a stand, and on the back is a power button. I will make sure that these are charge-free as well. They have a 3 to 4 hour battery life fully charged. So typically you'll be at an event for 2 or 3 hours. So it should last the entire time. For some reason it dies. It's really not the end of the world. You can just put it back in the box and it'll be A-okay. A remote comes with it. So this is the screen that will come up. Oops. Let's press the button. When you turn it on, you can then use the remote. Put the USB drive in there first. Here we go to movie. USB. Sorry, y'all cannot see. And then there's only one video on it. It's called Lobby TVs. It's the same slideshow that's going on the TV in the lobby. Play. It's loading. And it's just going to cycle through the same slideshow over and over and over again until you tell it to stop. So we'll let that kind of do its thing. And iPads now as well. Like I said, we're very high tech. The code is all zeros, but I am going to work on getting like a handout that has like step-by-step for the screens, step-by-step for the iPad, so that we don't have to worry about memorizing codes and steps and everything today. All zeros, like I said. And then, ideally, you can pull up our website and put it either on our adoptable dogs or adoptable cats, so that way if people are wanting to look through those at an event, they can do so. Most of the time we won't have actual animals on site at the event, but this gives people an opportunity to still kind of see the animals that we have available. And also gives you an opportunity to like talk about dogs and cats if that's what you're passionate about and that's why you're there and what you're wanting to do. And also, like I said, you have access to our full website. So if people have questions and you're not 100% sure the answer, you can go to our website and kind of point them in the right direction, or at least let them know, hey, that's probably on our website, you can go check it out. And then Allie was so kind to make a frequently asked questions little cheat sheet for you guys. So if you would come up and ask your question and not sure the answer, there's a good chance that it's in this handout somewhere. And if not, it's okay to not know the answer to something. You can just tell them to give us a call, reach out to us via email, and we'll point them in the right direction and be able to answer their question. the last thing in the cart are two chairs, so y'all don't have to stand the whole time. You have somewhere to sit. Some events will like provide like the metal folding chairs, or if you're inside like a restaurant or something, they'll have chairs for you as well. But this way, if you're outside at an event, you're not stuck standing the entire time. Endless, right? Are there any questions about all of the stuff in the cart and like setting the table up and everything? Okay, cool.
Pretty cool.
Yes. I'm very happy with it. I'm excited. Like I said, we just got the TV screens, the wheels I just set up the other day, so I haven't been to an event with all this stuff yet either, so I'm really excited to kind of see how that improves our presence at these events. Once you're at an event, a couple things to expect if you guys haven't been to them. It typically is just like people wanting to either donate or ask questions or just like kind of ask who we are, where we're at. I've gotten a lot of questions like, well, where are you located? Or like, do you have dogs? Do you have cats? Do you have rabbits? So it's really those typical questions that you'll get. Some people will come up to me like, I got my cat from the Humane Society. I got my dog from there. And that's always exciting to like see people who've adopted from us. So the events are really enjoyable, and I'm hoping that they're even more fun now that we have all this good stuff. When you pick up the cart, I do ask that you fill out this event cart checkout that will be sitting next to the cart. I will have the name of the event, hopefully the point of contact on here as well, in case you didn't get my email. You can either take a picture of this or put it in your phone really quick so that way you know who you're contacting. And then your name, whoever is going or picking up the cart. So that way, if there are multiple events going on, there could be two separate carts with two separate events on them. Just make sure you take the one that has your name and your event, because the things in the cart might be different depending on the event you're going to. Checkout date and time. So if you don't mind just putting the date that you picked it up. And then this is honestly the most important, is your planned return date and time. I don't need like 3:07 p.m., but I do need like a general like Monday afternoon. So that way I know that I'm gonna get this stuff all back before our next event happens.
So like if it was sort of late, you can come the next day.
Yes, yeah. Mm-hmm. So for those of you who may not know, we're open 10 to 6, Monday through Saturday. So if you do get done with an event and you want to bring it straight back, you can. But let's say your event ends at 7 p.m., you can bring it back anytime the next day or the next day. Please try and keep it like within the next day or two. Like I said, we're all super busy with events this next month, but once we start hitting the summer months, it does get pretty back to back. So we might need that cart the next day or two, and we need to make sure that we have it available. If for some reason you can't, just let me know, give me a call, shoot me an email, and that way I can at least like gather up some supplies to take to the next event coming up. My email and phone number are on here as well, so you're welcome to like take a picture of it or anything, but this will stay like where you pick up the carts, that way I have this. When you return the cart, please do your best to put things in here somewhat neatly. It doesn't have to be perfect, but especially now that we have all this technology going, I just want to make sure nothing is broken, and we try and keep it protected. Speaking about the technology as well, another big reason for having at least two people at an event is to keep an eye on this stuff. So, unfortunately, we live in a world where things do get stolen sometimes. So, if there's one person that turns their back and is talking to someone, it's nice to have someone else that's still keeping an eye on these things. It's maybe very quick and easy to grab the iPad, walk off with it in a busy crowd at an event, and nobody would ever know where it went. Bathroom breaks, too. I've been to an event by myself. Couldn't walk away from the table for 3 or 4 hours, and I was like, all right, I really gotta go. So it's awesome, nice to have a second person there for that reason. Bathroom breaks, if you wanna go get water, if you wanna go explore the event for a couple minutes, and the other person you're with is okay with that, it is just very helpful to have that second person there with you.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, of course.
So when you have it listed or whatever, mm-hmm. you set it up, just put two slots there.
Yeah.
And we will know that there's another person.
Correct. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
And you said somebody, if you took a friend, I mean, can they go with you and they're not volunteer?
Ideally, we do want people to be volunteers, okay. just so that way they have the like knowledge of the organization and just are signed up and have the liability waiver signed in case anything were to happen. But if you were to be signed up by yourself, and want someone to come help you, it's totally fine. Just let us know. She did ask, will I know if there's a second person signed up? So usually a couple days before the event, we'll make that last like call to try and get a second person. And if we don't, there is potential that we'll cancel the event, because like I said, it's a lot to do by yourself. So we'll let you know. We'll give you a call or shoot you an email. Just like, hey, like unfortunately no one else signed up. So we're gonna let the event coordinator know at the place that we're not able to make it, unfortunately. If that happens, I'll try and step in and be that second person if I'm not already somewhere else or like have something else scheduled. But we don't want you to be stuck somewhere by yourself. Yes. No, I totally understand. We're trying to get involved in larger events this coming year, just where there's like more people and more traffic coming through. And look at our table and learn about us. I'm trying to think of something I've done. I did like a Halloween festival this year, where we set up outside and there was like a pet costume contest, a person costume contest, and all kinds of fun things there.
If you went to that, you dress up.
Yes. Businesses that reach out and ask us that they're putting on a little something, like, do you want to be a part of it? And like I said before, that's where you guys really come into play, is there's multiple events, and I would have to choose the one to go to that's, like, larger, but if I have volunteers, then we can make sure we can go to both, which is great. I don't want to have to say no to someone who's asking us or inviting us to come to their event. I'm gonna have you guys follow me real quick just so I can show you guys where the event cart is kept, as well as where the tent is if you were to need it for an event. And then if you guys aren't already signed up to volunteer with us, go back there. If you'll come back to this room to meet with Allie real quick, she'll help you go ahead and get signed up to volunteer and get in our volunteer database. If you think that this is something that you're interested in and want to keep pushing through and doing with us, and then after that, you guys are all set to go.